Welcome back. In the last class, we talked about the definition of the temperature and pressure, and how the definition which relates entropy to the other variables, which appears to be abstract, fulfills the observation which we know about the pressure and temperature. Okay, and also we related to the temperature difference to the heat flow, pressure difference to the volume flow. Okay, now. I will focus on the equilibrium with respect to the matter flow. Okay. Now, what we are interested in is the flow of matter, let us say from one compartment to another compartment by considering let us say a rigid air partition, but diathermal okay, and as well as permeable. So, they are basically it is a porous in nature which allows particle to exchange from one compartment to another compartment. So, what we are going to consider is permeable to one type, okay, let us say of N1. Okay. So, this particular partition allows only one type of species, but for other species is impermeable. Okay, so that is the assumption which we are having here. Now, the reason why we are considering this is because the matter flow will provide insight to the chemical potential which we have considered in our basic thermodynamic functions for entropy or internal energy. Okay, so let me write down the basic equations here, but before that, since we are going to apply the entropy in maximum criteria, we have to make sure this is also isolated completely. So, you have compartment 1 and this is 2. Okay. So, let us write down the basic entropy in terms of differential value or differential terms. So, considering that this is rigid, this two compartment. Your dV1 is 0 as well as dV2. So, with that, the terms which are going to be relevant for us, so I can write down these terms. Okay, since it is impermeable to other type, that means the moles of all other species in compartment 1 or 2 is going to be 0. Okay. So, this term is only for type 1 species. Okay. Similarly, I can write for second compartment. Now, considering this to be 0, dS1 is going to be only this plus this term. So, we can write dS as dS1 plus dS2, okay, and now I can simply write this as without writing the expression for dS2 here, I am directly putting the expression in this final expression. okay. So this is the chemical potential of type 1 in compartment 1, this is the chemical potential of type 1 in compartment 2, okay. This is temperature in compartment 2, and this is dN, this is dN 1 in 2, okay. So that is the expression for dS. Now we know dU, the total energy here is constant, okay. Similarly, the total number of moles of species 1 in both the compartment will be constant, okay. So we are not assuming any reaction to happen, this is a simple system at this point. So N1 plus N2 is going to be constant, okay. So this will lead to the fact that this is constant. This means dU2 is minus dU1. This also means dN12, okay. Now you can plug this expression back to dS, and this will get simplified as minus okay, and this will be dN2, sorry, dN1 1. Okay. Now dS has to be 0. Okay, at the extremum condition, and for any arbitrary value of u1 and n1, so which essentially means that this is equal to 0 and this is equal to 0, which implies the temperature has to be same at equilibrium, which we now very well understand from the these derivations and earlier derivations of the two kinds which we have considered. And if temperature is same and this has to be same, mu by T basically should be constant or should be same. So this essentially means that mu 1 chemical potential of type 1 in 1 will be same as chemical potential of type 1 in compartment 2, okay. Now note that we have allowed only one particular species to move. What if all of the species were moving, okay. So essentially you can extract this, that if all of them are permeable, then your final compartment will have some chemical potential. So let me rephrase here again. This is for only one particular species which can pass through the partition. If you have more than one, for example, this extension, this particular definition can be extended to an arbitrary value of type 1 in compartment 1 should be same as that particular type I in compartment 2. So for any arbitrary value of I or specific species of type I, okay, if they can move back and forth through the partition, then the chemical potential in the compartment 1 should be same as chemical potential of that same type in compartment 2. So this is nothing but a chemical equilibrium condition. Okay. Now you can relate this, this is a condition for the chemical equilibrium. So assuming again the same way as we have done for the pressure, let us assume that you have considered a constant temperature system in both the compartment. In that case, your this term is going to be 0, okay. So only the dS can be related to the difference in mu by T. I can write this expression again as assuming that T1 is T2 condition, special case. So this means dS is mu 1 T okay, divided by Tn1, okay. Now, if mu 1, okay, so if a chemical potential of type 1, in this case where only one particular species can pass through the partition, if chemical potential in compartment 1 is greater than chemical potential of compartment 2, what would be the direction of the flow or of particular matter? That means which compartment will allow the particles to move from itself to another compartment, and that's something which we can consider based on this. So if this is the case, which essentially means this is going to be negative, since ds is going to be positive, which essentially means dn1 is going to be negative, okay. So in this case, matter flow from 1 to 2, or in other words, matter flow matter tends to flow from high chemical potential to low chemical potential. So that is something which we wanted to discuss here. We have beautifully connected the thermodynamic definition, our intuitions, to thermal equilibrium, heat flow, pressure equilibrium, volume flow, and chemical equilibrium to the matter flow. Okay, so with this, we'll stop at this junction, and we'll take up a new topic in the next lecture. Okay, so have a good day.